Good morning. My name is M.B. Zahida Parveen. I am working as an assistant professor in St. Martin's Engineering College. So today my topic is compiler design. When we are talking about a compiler design, what is a compiler design? What is a compiler? Compiler is nothing but a software which converts your high-level language into a low-level language. So while doing that one, whatever the code you write in high-level language, which is nothing but in C, Java, C++, whatever the user-understandable language, whatever the code you write in the user-understandable language, it gets converted into low-level language. So while doing this one, we have different software modules that are preprocessor, compiler, assembler, linker loader, that will get converted into target language. So what happens here? These are the different software modules which convert your high-level language into low-level language. Here, high-level language is nothing but this is the code which is directly written by a user. The user writes a Java program or C program, and that is nothing but the high-level language. That high-level language is given to the preprocessor. So what does the preprocessor do? It converts the statements you write like hash include, hash define, the statements you write in the high level language, these files are included. These are replaced by the particular files and then get converted into pure high level language. This high level language gets converted into pure high level language after replacing this expansion, like micro expansion or file inclusion. These file inclusion and micro expansions are done in preprocessor, and this high level language which is written by the user gets converted into pure high level language. Now this pure high level language is given to the compiler, and this compiler converts this one into assembly language. Now this assembly language is converted based on the operating system. Here it does not have any dependency on the operating system. But once the compiler, when it converts into the assembly language, now this assembly language is fed into the assembler, and from here the code will be converted into the binary language or the target language by depending upon the operating system. So this assembler takes the assembly language and then converts into machine relocatable language. Now this machine relocatable language is directly converted into binary language by using linker and loader. These are the different software modules which converts your high level language into the pure binary language, which is nothing but the pure machine language, low level language. So these all are the software modules which are theoretically these are the different modules, but when we are talking about in practical, whenever we are seeing in a Turbo C or your GCC, whatever the code blocks compiler, then we cannot find these all as separate modules. These all are just combined in that. Whenever you try to execute a file, that directly converts, that directly takes your Java file or a C file and that directly converts into the binary. So in our compiler design course, we are just focusing on the compiler software module. So in the compiler software module, what we have seen, it takes the input as a pure high level language. It takes pure high level language as an input, and then it converts into assembly language. To convert that one, we have a compiler uses or moves through different phases. Moves through six different phases, and then it converts into target code, which is nothing but assembly language. So in a compiler there are six different phases that are lexical analysis phase, syntax analysis phase, semantic analysis phase, intermediate code generation phase, and code optimization phase. And this code optimization phase directly converts into an assembly language based upon the operating system of the user is using. So what it is happening here? What it actually does? This high level language is nothing but the pure high level language which it receives from the preprocessor. It means that here we cannot find any hash include or hash define stream of characters. This stream of characters are given to the lexical analysis phase, and this lexical analysis phase converts that one into stream of tokens, or you can also tell as stream of lexemes. Okay, these characters are converted into tokens. So how does it convert? This lexical analysis phase takes grammar, or you can understand like NFA or DFA, or it takes some patterns. It uses lexical analysis phase, uses patterns to identify these characters, and it converts into tokens. For example, if I have a statement like x is equal to a plus b into c, if I have a statement which is nothing but x is equal to a plus b into c, now this lexical analysis phase, it converts into patterns. First it will identify, these are nothing but stream of characters. Now it will be taking each and every variable as a particular token. First it will be differentiating, it will separate, and after separating, after classifying, it will try to identify based upon the patterns. As an x is nothing but an identifier, equal to is nothing but an operator, a is nothing but an identifier, plus is nothing but an operator. So based upon the patterns, it will try to identify what is the statement given, and it converts this one into a stream of tokens, which is nothing but identifier is equal to identifier plus identifier into identifier. Now this stream of characters are converted into stream of tokens. Now this stream of tokens are given into syntax analysis phase. So whenever in lexical analysis phase, whenever it tries to convert from a stream of characters to stream of tokens, it also does one other thing. What it does, it removes spaces. It removes spaces, extra spaces or new lines, whatever the user has written in the program, it will remove that one. And it will identify, like for example, if I have initialized int x, comma, a comma b comma c, and a is equal, if I initialize a is equal to 0 or something, x is equal to 0, then this sort of information, what is the user is trying to say? User is telling that a, b, c and x are nothing but the variables which are having integer data type. Okay, this information is also stored by the lexical analyzer in symbol table. In this symbol table, the lexical analyzer stores the information related to these identifiers. What is the data type of identifier? What is the size of an identifier? This sort of information will be stored in the symbol table by lexical analysis phase. So these two have a communication. Now, whenever this lexical analysis phase stores the information of a particular variables, this information is used by other phases of a compiler. So this symbol table is having communication with each and every other phases of the compiler. By using the information stored by the lexical analysis, they can execute and they can understand the meaning of a particular state. So now in the lexical analysis phase, stream of characters are converted into stream of tokens. Now the stream of tokens are given to the syntax analysis. Now the syntax analysis in phase, what it does, it converts the stream of tokens into parse tree. This stream of tokens are converted into parse tree. To convert that stream of tokens, which are nothing but, now I got a stream of tokens like id is equal to id plus id into id. I got the stream of tokens. I try to convert this stream of tokens into parse tree based on grammar, or you can understand as rules or number of productions. By using a grammar, by using different rules and or the productions of the grammar, it will try to compare whether the stream of tokens satisfies the grammar or not. So that it can understand whether it is ambiguous or whether it is having any problem with the syntax. Like, for suppose, if it has written like there is no semicolon, then it will understand. By using the grammar, it will understand that this statement is not complete. And here it raises a problem like syntax error. So this syntax error or errors is handled by the error handler. In whatever the phases, if the compiler is facing any problem, that problem will be raised by the error handler. Now, for example, as we have seen, stream of code is converted into parse stream by using a grammar. Here I have a stream of tokens like id is equal to id plus id into id. Now I am using some grammar like some predictions like whenever we try to parse or derive a tree, we need to start it with a starting symbol. So I am giving a grammar like sp writes id is equal to expression or expression derives expression plus term or term derives term into factor or a factor derives an id. For this example, I am using this grammar. Now, by using this grammar, the syntax analysis have to parse this stream of lexemes. Now, how to derive this one? Whenever trying to derive, I need to get this particular statement. So, as whenever we derive, it starts with the starting symbol. So, s derives id is equal to expression again. This expression derives expression plus term. Again, this term derives. This is derived as T and F. Again, this term as factor. This as factor. This as ID. And this as ID. And this as ID. After parsing, I need to get a parse string which satisfies the statement. See here, ID is equal to id plus id into id semicolon. It means that whatever the statement it is given, it is satisfying the grammar. So that I can parse this particular statement. Now this is the parse tree which we got from the syntax analysis. Well, syntax analysis gives an output as a parse tree. Now this parse tree is given to the semantic analysis. This semantic analysis, by the name itself, we can understand that it will check for the meaning whether the statement given is correct or not. It will be checking by whatever, whenever the lexical analysis has given the information about the data types. For example, if you think, if C is a character and all others are integers, I cannot store that information or I cannot multiply and I cannot store the information in X variable. So that sort of semantic analysis will be done in this phase, and it will check for the meaning and it will be produced a semantically verified parse tree. You will be getting a tree that is nothing but semantically verified parse tree, and this semantically verified parse tree will be given to the intermediate code generation. So now your lexical analysis, syntax analysis, semantic and intermediate code generation are called as front end. Why? Because this does not convert based upon the operating system. It is independent of an operating system. Whenever the semantically verified parse tree is given to the intermediate code generation, it will try to convert this one based upon the intermediate code. For example, we have three address code generator. Three address code generator are there. In our example, here we can see there are four addresses. So we will try to convert that one into three address code generator. For example, I will be taking like T1 is equal to B into C and T2 is equal to A plus T1 and then X is equal to T2. Now I am taking here three addresses. Which three addresses will be doing the work of a particular statement? Now here, from here, this in code optimization phase, what it does is nothing but it try to minimize the code. It try to optimize the code. If there are any unnecessary statements which take some extra time, that will be removed. That will be optimized. For example, now this x is equal to t2 is unnecessary statement. I can reduce this one. I can reduce this one as x is equal to A plus T1. Instead of writing these two statements, I can directly write it as x is equal to A plus T1. the target code, which is nothing but the assembly code, based upon the operating system of an user is using. Like if an operating, if the user is using an resistors format of operating system, then it will be converting into a resistor format. For example, if in computer organization we have seen different assemblers like 8081, 8086, then what we'll be doing, we'll be assigning or we will be adding the data into a resistors, and that resistors will be operated on that resistors will be operating. Like for example, now I have something like T is equal to B into C. Now I will be moving R0 is equal to A or R1 is equal to B, and I am assigning these values, A value into resistor 0, B value into resistor 1, C value into resistor 2. Now by using these values, what I will be doing, I will be operating on these resistors. First, what I need to do, I need to multiply B into C. What are these B into C? I need to tell like multiplication of R1 and R2. Whenever I am trying to multiply this R1 and R2, after doing the operation, it will be saving the data into R2 register. Again, what is the next expression I have to do? Add R0, R2. Next, what it will be happening? Whatever the data I am getting from this operation, that will be saved in R2, and whatever the value I am getting this one, by using this operation, it will be performing the operation again, that data will be saved in R2. Next, what do we need to get? We need to assign, like store R2 X. It means that whatever the data is in R2, that will be stored in X. By this, we can directly access X to get the output. So, whatever the example, whatever the statement you have given, that will be get converted into assembly language. Into assembly language, which is understandable by the particular user's operating system. So here in the compiler, what it does, it takes a statement, it will understand, and it will convert into an assembly language, which is also a low level language but not pure binary language. This is intermediate. It is not completely a high level language or not a completely a binary language like zeros and ones. And after doing this, this assembler will be taking this information and then internally it will be converting into zeros and ones. That is completely or pure